Welcome to a course on limits and continuity. In the previous lecture, we have seen some results relating the continuity and compactness. In this lecture also, we are going to continue with the same. Here, actually in the theorem, continuous image of a compact set is compact. Actually, there is a typographical, okay. So here we have seen what we have done. We have done F inverse of F of V is contained in V, right? So this is what we have proved. In simple words, what we have done, okay, let me make use of this space, okay? We proved F inverse of E, and then we have F of E. This is contained in E. This is what we have proved. Here, where was E? When we E is a subset of Y. Okay. So, for a subset E of Y. What is Y? F is a mapping that is defined from X to Y. This is the case that we were discussing. And if you consider another subset F for a subset F of X, if we are considering a subset of X, then we shall find F of F first, okay, and then we shall apply F inverse. What is the relation between this and this? This is what we are going to see now. Just consider, even here the concept of continuity is not required. It is enough to simply check with the definition of mapping itself, right? Let me consider 1, 2, 3, 4 here and ABC here. Let 1 maps with A and 2 maps with B and C maps with C and 4 maps with C. Okay. Here, I'll have to consider a subset of X, right? So, the subset that I'm going to consider is 2 and 3. Okay. And what is F of F? It's going to be B, C. Now, what is F inverse of F of F? This is the inverse images of B and C, right? B has the inverse image 2 and C has the inverse images 3 and 4, and this happens to be the set 2, 3, 4. So, we'll have to compare this set 2, 3, 4 with 2, 3, and this is the superset, right? So, this is the relation that we are going to have. Whenever you take a subset of Y, you can first find the inverse images of that subset and then find the image of that subset. That will be a subset of E. And if you take a subset of X, and the reverse inequality holds. Okay. Equality may not hold in both the cases. Here in this example, the examples that I provided you, we do not have the equality. If you take any other subset, so for example, if you take 1 and 2, you will have the equality, right? When your function is 1, 1 and on 2, okay? Let me remark that here. Let me do it in different color, okay? The remarks that I would like to make here is, when a function is 1, 1 and on 2, then you will have F inverse of F of E is E and F of F inverse of E. Okay, so I should use different notations to make the idea clear, right? This is E for subsets. F is a subset taken from F of X and E of Y. So, this is the thing that are taking place. Let us move to the theorem. In this theorem, we are given that F is a continuous real valued function on a compact metric space X. Okay. Here, we will have to closely look at the terms. It is a continuous function, real function on a compact metric space X. So, given that F is a mapping defined from X to R, where X is what? X is a compact metric space. Okay. Since F is continuous, F of X is compact. Using the fact that is using the result that continuous image of compact set is compact. Clear? Okay. Now what we have? We have F of X is compact where in R. And now R is a Euclidean space which implies compact set. A set is said to be compact in a Euclidean space if and only if the set is closed and bounded. Okay. Since F of X is bounded, there exists supremum of F of X and infimum of F of X, and let us denote the supremum as M and infimum as small m. Okay, this is what we are taking. Okay. Okay, the supremum is M and the infimum is small m, and now we are using the fact that this F of X is closed. Okay, we are taking the supremum. In this case, the supremum and infimum must be the members of F of X. Okay, since F of X is closed. Okay, since F of X is closed, this M must be a member of F of X, and small m is also a member of F of X. All the elements in F of X. Okay, this is one fact. The other fact, all elements y in F of X, y in F of X has a corresponding x in X such that F of X is y. Okay. With this, let me conclude. Let me write in the top. We have started since, right? So since this is the case, as a correspond, then there exists some points P comma Q in X such that F of P is M and F of Q is small m, and this completes the proof. Okay, here what are the things that we have made use of? We have made use of the compact concept that the continuous image of compact set is compact. A set is compact in a Euclidean metric space if and only if it is closed and bounded. If it is bounded, there exist two finite bounds such that the supremum and the infimum, that is what we name them, right? And since the set is closed, the supremum and infimum must be a members of the set. Okay, what is the set that we are dealing about? It is the image set, image of some set under a continuous mapping, which means all the elements in this F of X must have a corresponding element in X, the metric space X. Those elements we name them as P and Q. That's it.
The next theorem that we are going to see is given as follows. Here we are given that F is a continuous 1-1 mapping of a compact metric space onto a metric space Y. So we shall start are proved by writing given f from x to y is a continuous mapping. Okay, this mapping is also 1-1 and onto, where x is a compact metric space. So this is what we are given. Whenever a mapping is both 1-1 and onto, the inverse mapping F inverse, which is defined from y to x, exists and is 1-1 and onto. This is the basic fundamental result that one might have studied in the course of abstract algebra. So with this, we directly write this. Still now, we have not made use of the concept that this function is continuous. With the help of that continuity, we are about to prove the continuity of the inverse image. This one exists and this 1-1 and onto that we have said. How does it exist? Here, f inverse of f of x is going to be x, and this is true for all x in the metric space x. Okay, now we will make use of the fact that x is compact. Since x is compact and f is continuous, we get f of x is compact in y. Okay, so this we have. If it is compact, then compact subset of a metric spaces are closed. So those are the ideas that we have to remember to proceed with the proof of this theorem. Okay, here to prove F inverse is continuous, we are going to make use of the topological definition of continuity. That is, a function is continuous. Okay, let me write it more precisely. F from x to y is continuous if and only if f inverse of v is open in x for every v open in y. So the same idea we will have to apply for this theorem. So that means in the place of f, we are going to have f inverse. So what is f inverse of whole inverse? Here, f inverse of v, here, this F inverse of V just means the inverse collection of inverse images of every element in V. That's it we are meaning by F inverse of V. Okay. The context that we use here is the inverse of a mapping. We'll have to understand these things in a clear way. So, in order to prove F inverse is continuous, okay, so let me write that. In order to prove F inverse is continuous, it is enough to prove F inverse the whole inverse of V, which turns to be simply f of v, okay, is open in y. Here the domain of f inverse is y, that is why we have y, is open in y for every open set v in x. So this is what we have to prove. Okay, now let me take an open set. Let v be in open set in X. If V is an open set in X, then of course V complement is closed in X. Okay, this is good. So, what is the thing we have here? Okay, let me write this way. V complement being a closed subset of a compact set, actually a compact matrix space of a compact set X. This V complement is compact, because we have seen in the course of topology that closed subset of a closed subset of a compact set is compact. That using that result, we conclude that V complement is compact, and the continuous image of compact sets are compact. Using that, we shall conclude that F of V complement is compact in Y. So F of V complement being a compact set in Y leads to a conclusion that F of V complement is closed. Since compact subsets of compact subsets of metric spaces are closed. Using this, we come to a conclusion that F of V complement is closed. If this is closed, this tells you that F of V complement, the whole complement is open. This is open in where? In Y. Okay. Just because the function is 1, 1 and on 2, since F is 1, 1 and on 2, we get F of V complement, the whole complement turns to be F of V. That is F of V complement this is due to the fact that F of A, for any set A, whole complement is simply F of A complement. So using this, we write this way. Okay, what we get, this is open in Y, which means my F of V is open in Y. This is what we needed to prove, right? So whatever may be the open set that I choose in X, I am able to find that F of V is open in Y. This proves F inverse is continuous. So actually, let me write it completely. F of V is open in Y for every open set V in X. So we come to a conclusion that F inverse is continuous, and this completes the proof. Thank you.